Would you like to know why it's so hard for employers to hire cloud architects, enterprise architects, security architects, and AI architects, and why we architects get paid so much? If so, this video is for you. My name is Michael Gibbs, and I'm the founder and CEO of Go Cloud Careers, and I've been every type of IT architect you can think of in the last 25 years. A network architect, an enterprise architect, a cloud architect, a business architect, you name it, and I love architecture careers. And I too have been an employer that struggles to hire capable and qualified applicants. And I want you to understand why this is, so if you desire to become an architect, you can become a great architect and get any job you absolutely desire. So, it is near impossible to hire a capable cloud architect, enterprise architect, AI architect, network architect, security architect. And these roles are often elusive to job seekers. They go and get 4 and 5 certifications, they learn all these skills, and they can't make it through the architect interview. And I'm going to explain to you why. What's going on here is really a combination of 3 problems. It's a misunderstanding of the architecture roles. It's a training mismatch. And that leads to a skills mismatch where people are trained and they have really good skills. Unfortunately, they're not related to the skills that the architect would need for their job. So what's really going on here? The architects that we interview, generally speaking, have different skills. Maybe they have coding skills. Maybe they have engineering skills. Maybe they have sysops or maintenance skills. But they lack actual architecture skills. So what is it that we do as architects? Regardless of whether you're an AI architect or a cloud architect or an enterprise architect, you're designing a solution for a business to optimize their performance. So our solutions involve the organization's people, the organization's processes, and the organization's technology, because that's what goes into a business. And if the architect doesn't have the business skills, they will be unable to get an architecture job. Now, Gartner is an organization that evaluates, you know, the newest trends, newest firewalls, most innovative clouds, what have you. And they started looking and saying, why are there so many weird cloud architect job descriptions? What's going on with this funny cloud architect role? So they did what any great research organization would do. And they asked the people that hire the architects, what are you looking for in an architect? In fact, they asked the top of the IT organizations, the chief information officer, and they said, what do you want in an architect? What do you want them to do? What do you want them to be good at? And of course, they published the results in CIO magazine, and you can look at this article for yourself. But I'll summarize it for you. When CIOs are asked, what do you want in a cloud architect? They say, we would like someone that can lead the cultural change for cloud adoption, develop and coordinate a cloud architecture, and that means designing the architecture and leading the architecture team. And they say we would like someone that can develop the cloud strategy and coordinate the adoption process. So what does that mean? Creation of the actual architecture design, what to go hybrid cloud, multi-cloud, hybrid multi-cloud, what have you, the types of systems that are needed. And then after that, the creation of a statement of work to see what kind of people are necessary to build the system, because architects don't build systems. We design systems. Now, when they ask the CIOs what you want in the architects, what you think they'll be doing every day, they'll say, helping to find talent with the necessary skills. And in my architecture career, I've been building architecture teams and interviewing thousands of people, because that's a big part of our role. They also say assessing applications, software, and hardware, which is exactly what I've done as an architect. I look at that organization's technology systems, and I see what they have which works, what they have which doesn't work, and will the system they have get them to their future goals? And if not, it's time for a new system design. They talk about creating a cloud broker team. Now, a cloud broker team are all the people that are going to be involved in the design. And it might be a cloud architect, a network architect, a security architect, an IAM architect, a data scientist, an AI architect, and potentially some cloud engineers and DevOps engineers, because they're going to be the technical experts on some of the technology. They are our go-to resource because we are focused on the designing for the business and they are focused on the tech. So the next thing that the CIO said is we would like someone to help establish best practices for cloud across the company. How will you use the cloud? How can we create a standard, which for like a standard type of system that we will use, what have you? And then they talk about selecting cloud providers and vetting third-party services. Well, in today's world, 98% of organizations are multi-cloud. So which clouds do you use and which other services do you use? For example, for security, you may go to a security vendor like Palo Alto as opposed to using the cloud vendor's native tools. The next thing the CIOs say we want in a cloud architect or someone that can help oversee governance and mitigate risk. And that's creating the governance team that will actually be oversee the implementation, the leaders, the stakeholders from key divisions. They talk about working closely with IT security people to monitor privacy and develop incident response procedures. Absolutely. So the security policy for the organization, the type of security standards that our organization needs to do, what happens when an incident occurs, those types of things. They also want the cloud architect to manage budget and estimate cost and help the organization operate at scale, full scale for that enterprise. So these are what we do as cloud architects. Now, when many people want to become an architect, what do? Well, they learn how to build. An architect designs, a builder builds. They're two different jobs. When I went through that entire list of architect skills from CIO Magazine, what didn't they include? They didn't include configure. They didn't include code. They didn't include Linux. They didn't include Python. They didn't include Terraform. No DevOps, no SysOps, no tech support, none of that. These are very important skills performed by very strong and smart engineers, but it's not the architect's job. We are focused on the big picture. They are focused on putting these systems to actual together. So what happens is people go and they learn all these things. They learn Linux. They learn Python. They learn how to code. They learn DevOps. They learn how to SysOps. And then they go on an interview. And when someone asks you, how would you design a system for this business problem? They don't know because they have a very good set of skills, but it's not the right set of skills for the architect. So that's the skills mismatch. So I want you to think about this. How do we take a person that is built and trained to be a builder and ask them to be a planner? That's why nobody asks the construction workers who build beautiful buildings to actually design the skyscraper, the next hotel, or the next shopping mall. Architects design it, and the construction crew or the engineers go build it. And if you think about learning how to build and expecting it to teach you how to do something else, think about learning how to fly an airplane. You know how to fly the plane, get people from point A to point B. It's very important. But you know who nobody hires these pilots to do? They don't get hired by NASA to design the next rocket ship. And why? They are experts at flying the systems, not necessarily designing the systems. So what skills do you really need to be a great architect? And what do you need to learn to get hired? Well, it's a combination of business skills and tech skills. And we have a completely free ebook that's in the description of this video that will give you a list of every single skill. But it's related to your presentation skills. It's related to your sales skills. It's related to your executive presence. It's related to your knowledge of business. It's related to your ability to lead large teams. And on the technical side, it's designing the systems. Now, if we think about designing systems, that means we need to think about networking, we need to think about security, we need to think about compute, we need to think about storage, we need to think about so many other things, including the applications themselves and what it's going to take to drive transformation or business enhancement for that business. So the architect's tech skills are more about how does the technology work and how do you put it together, as opposed to the building skills of the builder. And in a minute, we'll get into why we get paid so much, but I want to teach you the difference in skills. Many people use their computer every single day of the week, and they have great hands-on experience. That's the equivalent of building skills. But if I ask 99% of the population that uses their computer every day to tell me about their CPU, to tell me about the type of instructions the CPU can use, to tell me about the inner core communication and what those cores do, to talk to me about the clock rate and single core performance versus multi-threaded performance and when higher clock rates versus more cores would be appropriate in their architecture. If I ask them to tell me about the level 1, level 2, and level 3 cache in the CPU and how does that work, or if I ask them how many PCI lanes does that CPU use and how will that determine your design for a multi-GPU compute system used in AI, they won't know. So for us, it's learning how the systems work, not how to build them, and how to integrate them together in a manner that will solve business problems. Now, let's talk about why we get paid so much. Well, first, the architect role is an executive role. It takes a big combination of business skills and tech skills. So business skills are typically more expensive to learn, and business people typically get paid more. So there's that. But if you've ever thought about that supply and demand curve, you know, that X, for example, that you would have seen in an economics class, you'll remember this. If there's a big demand for someone and there's a huge demand for architects and there's no supply or there's lack of people that can actually do the job or have the right skills for the job, then you find yourself in the perfect position. Huge demand, low supply equals high price. That combination of business skills and tech skills and the ability of an architect to enhance business performance makes them worth their weight in gold, diamonds, and platinum. So please download that book because I want you to get the best architect job you desire. And why don't you join us for a free webinar on how to become a cloud architect or an enterprise architect or an AI architect, because these are great careers and I want you to learn more about them in case there's something you're interested in your future. And if you enjoyed this video, please give it a like. Please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to help you in your technology career. This is Mike Gibbs signing off for now, and I look forward to seeing you in another video. Take care.